make you fishers of men, fishers of men, fishers of men. I will make you fishers of men if you follow me. I will make you fishers of men if you follow me.
He won Aaron. What was the warning? Amen. Aaron heard what? His peace. We will go there later. In second test, before the second test, Aaron became afraid of who? Of God. His two sons that remained became afraid of who? God. All Israelites that had this, Israel became afraid of who? Why? God have sanctified his name. Also glorify his name. In the days of the New Testament church, it also happened when brother Joseph called the son of consolation in Acts chapter 4, the last two verses, brought, sold his landed property and brought the money to the apostles' feet, and they praised the Lord, they appreciated him, the brethren rejoiced. When Ananias and Sapphira heard that testimony, they said, let us do as they do. It was an imitation Christianity. It's not original. Imitation what? It's not what? Make I do as they do, not as God wants you to do. If you're a Christian, you are not following God direct, you are not listening to God to know what he wants you to do, you are borrowing from other church. When they clap and you clap, when they raise oil, when they bring anointing, you bring, when they dress like this, you are imitation. If you want to be original, go to the secret place of the Most who of my God. He will reveal himself to you. People are following people up and down and not following God. Following other ministries and other ministers, not following God. You say, my daddy says so, my pastor says so. What of what the Lord said? It become imitation. What do I call it? Imitation. And then I said to the wife, we have a property also, let us go and sell it. If we didn't do fast now, brother Joseph will be respected. Then we don't gonna respect us now. Probably I am, is my convert. I converted him. Probably he's a young convert to me. Look at the way everybody is praising him and they appreciate him. We can do the same. They went and sold their property. Nobody compelled them. It was not under compulsion. After selling it, he came to them and said, James, just you do it all well. Like say, but we no get there. We go use common. My wife said, honey, we are going to use what? Common sense. We'll be dressing like them, but they don't know we are not like them. We'll be talking like them, they don't know we're not with them. We have a mission, we have something in our mind, but they will think that we're with them. Let us be walking like the way they, let us cut the Bible the way pastor is, let us preach the way pastor is preaching. But they do not know that we have another. Say, what do we do? Say, let us share the money and bring part of the money. When we get to the apostles' feet, we say, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. As Joseph did the other day, God have helped us to do the same. We drop the money. They all will think that it is all. They will not know that we divided it. And when they ask us, say, now that is how much we sell our land. They agreed together. The husband left early and went to the apostles' feet when they are doing fellowship, and drop the money at the feet of Peter and say, oh, my reverend brother, my senior pastor, my senior apostle, I love you too much. You are my pastor, you are my party man, you are my daddy, you are my general. You, I know Peter, if not you, I don't know what him for in my life. And because of that, I have sold my landed world. Here is the money. I bring all to God. he turned to go, Peter said, "Brother Ananias, come. Is this amount you sold your land?" He said, "Yes, sir. My pastor, my spiritual daddy. I'm not a new convert. I was following John the Baptist before Jesus came. I followed him also when he died. And now I'm still following. At the upper room, I was there too. I received powers. You receive power. You don't know me. I'm not a new convert." And Peter said, "Brother Ananias, that landed property is your own. When you sold the money or the land, if you decide to bring part of it, it's still within your power. But why do you decided to lie against the Holy Spirit? You have not lied against me, Peter. You have not lied against the church. You have not lied against it, but against the Holy Spirit." And Bible says, while Peter hearing that very, very voice, he fell on the ground and died. Who killed him? Peter, who killed him? When he died, all the brethren, the church, who were there, fear came, trembling came. People were running head and scatter. Little liar, now little liar, no be fornication, no be adultery, no be going to native. Now little liar, half lie, half truth. He just died. And Peter's administration, that the wise may have been, you know, Bible says, after 3 hours, brethren, do you see the what we can, I don't know how to describe it, that the husband and wife prepared for church. The wife, the husband was already in the church for what? 3 hours before the wife come. 3 hours before the wife arrived. What was she doing? She want to hide the money. Many people don't know. Because they be homemaker. They be what? They be what? Homemaker. Say, "Daddy, they go. Let me arrange the house." She have to, you know, hide the money and put other ones, you know, decorate herself very well. And she just arrived. Peter look into her and say, "Sister Sephira." Say, "My Lord, my pastor, my bishop, my apostle." He said, "Is this so amount that the husband told her that you sold that land?" He said, "Oh, me and my husband, we have one purse. That's what you teach us. One purse, one language, one vision. And we have been practicing this poverty and holiness and unity. That is the amount we sold the land." Peter said, "Sephira, why do you connive with your husband to lie against the Spirit of the Lord? Look at the feet of those that buried your husband. They will also carry you and bury you by your side of your liar partner." Peter did not kill her. I would say, while she had that, what happened? She fell on the ground and also gave up the ghost. And the young men came in and saw her dead. They carried her again and went to bury her by her husband. I ask you again, who killed Sephira? You tell lie to your husband, they never catch you. Holy Ghost never kill you. Say, "I am free." You tell lie to your wife, they don't kill you immediately. You say, "Nothing that happened, no chicken." You tell lie to your parents, and they go New Guinea, and they go Lagos, and you are going another place, and because you are not caught, you feel that you are free. And all these boys who are running runs in the church, running runs around, have, you know, seen partners, even through internet and whatever, and you are, when you are running, what are you doing? "I am just preaching the gospel." Preaching what? The gospel. You are not yet dead, you feel that you're free. And so many don't know that every secret of man shall be soon revealed. All you do every day in your life is being recorded against the day of judgment. Your secrets, your nakedness, your thoughts, your imagination, your plan, whatever you're doing, they are on record, whether they be good or bad. So what is the fear now? I sit here. God anointed Aaron and with his four sons same day to offer sacrifice on behalf of the God's people, Israel. Aaron, their father, was ordained as the high priest, while his sons are to assist him in carrying out the father's instruction. So they were under their father's authority. But Nadab and Abihu, on their own, without their father's knowledge or approval, offered to God incense, which was described as a strange fire. That's why we should fear God. 1 Samuel chapter 13, 8 and 14. There was a man called Uzzah. You know the story, I may not read. When David was carrying the Ark of the Covenant, captured in the days of Eli and his children, when David became a king, he felt, why will I live in seed houses, live in palace, while the Ark of the Covenant or presence dwell in other people's house? He went to intent, he went to carry it, as he put it in the cart, and Ophini and another one called here, all of them were carrying the Ark, escorting the Ark. When they came to a particular place, there was galloping, and the axe or the cart bearing the ass, just wanting to, as if he want to, I want to fall. This man in his zeal, everybody says zeal. Zeal without knowledge, we end in disaster. With zeal, what was the zeal? How will I be here and see the Ark of Covenant? For where? On the ground. And the Ark of Covenant connotes God himself. Will God fall on the ground? Brethren, will God fall on the ground? I said, will God fall on the ground? But that's what Uzzah don't know. I want to help the church. I want to help the, you want, I want to fight for the church. God don't need you to fight for him. God don't need you. All he needs for you is obedience, fear, trembling. If Uzzah knew this, that zeal wouldn't have led to his death. Bible says Uzzah said, oh no, as he put his hand to hold the ark not to fall, what happened? The Lord killed him there. And when David saw that Uzzah died, Bible says David abandoned the ark there. What did he do? He was afraid. King David. He said, I know God before, but I know now this like this. So why would this boy die? He want to help the ark. Now the owner of ark is waiting. Kill him. Bible says David from that day was afraid to come near where? The ark. Who was David? The man after God's own heart. Who was David? The psalmist. Who was David? The man that knew how to praise and worship the Lord. Who was David? The king in Israel. Who was David? The anointed of God. He was afraid of the same God. Time has come where pastors will fear God, where ministers of the gospel will fear God, where leaders and workers, pastors, wives, pastors, children, we fear this God. He's loving, he's a covenant keeper, he wonder bless, but he can, where you contravene his holy order. and want to put your hand in his eyes, you will die. Also in 2 Chronicles 26 from 1 to 4, let's see that place. Another king from the lineage of David, his name was called Uzziah. The other one was Uzzah, but this one was Uzziah. Then all the people of Judah took Uzziah, who was 16 years old, and made him king in the room of his father Amaziah. He built a lot and restored it to Judah. After that, the king slept with his fathers, and 16 years old was Uzziah when he began to reign, and he reigned 52 years in Jerusalem. His mother's name also was Jesoleam of Jerusalem. And he did that which was right in the sight of the Lord, according to all that his father Amaziah did. And he brought and he sought God. Magdalene said he sought God. He is a prayer warrior, a committed, devoted man, a man of secret prayer, a man of open prayer, a man of holiness, a man of righteousness, a man of purity in and out. He sought the Lord. He sought the Lord. He was not a jolly man or whatever who eats everywhere. No, he sought God in the days of Zechariah, who has understanding in the vision of God. As long as he sought the Lord, God made him to do what? To prosper. God prospered him. Oh yes, God, what? Then let's see the end of this man. Verse 16 to 21. 16 to 21. But when he was strong, he had not been established. He had not been strong, prospered. He had not been exalted by God, honored by God, honored by me. But when he was strong, you know, he started ruling at the age of 60 years. Now he has ruled 50 something years. Now he is now between 60 something years or 70 years. Getting to 70 years, he was now strong. What did he do? Bible said that is, he became familiar with God, familiar with all the ordinances. And what Bible said, when he was strong, his heart was lifted up to his what? Destruction. For he transgressed against the Lord in his God, and went into the temple of the Lord to burn what? Incense upon the altar of what? The same thing with the sons of Aaron did. It is primarily exclusive duty of the priests and high priests to perform sacrifice, not the king. King is administrator of the people, the ruler of the people, while the prophet is God's spokesman to the people. Prophets were not even permitted to perform sacrifice unless those were given that role to play. But this time it was the priests, that high priest, that we ought to perform sacrifice. But this man said, I can do all. I am general overseer, I'm a choir master, I'm a Sunday school teacher, I can do all. In fact, with the anointing on my head now, nothing I cannot do. I can sleep with a woman and get up and cast out the devil. I can also tell things on lie and also continue, you know, speaking in tongues. You know, because I am not strong. The church have not grown. People have not respected me. You know, I'm no longer a newcomer. They have recognized me in the church. Anything. Nobody can touch me in the church now because I am very, very influential. Oh yes, God can touch you. If no man touch you, God can touch you. If no man can remove you, God will remove you. Amen. I say amen. I say amen. Bible said while he was attempting to do that, he was, you know, warm, tried to be discouraged by the leaders. But he went on. Let's see verse 17. And Azariah, the priest, went in after him, and with him for 80 priests of the Lord, 60 priests of the Lord, that we are valiant men. That people are young ones. And they withstood Uzziah the king, and said unto him, it appertaineth not unto thee. It's not, God do not allow you, God do not command you. It appertaineth unto thee, Uzziah, to burn incense unto the Lord, but to the priests, the sons of who? The sons of Aaron, that are consecrated to burn incense, go out of the sanctuary, for thou hast trespassed. Neither shall it be for thy own, for thy honor, from the Lord. The Lord will not honor you in this. He will not respect you in this. Please, we cancel you. Leave now. Leave now. Then Uzziah was what? Wroth, and had censer in his hand to burn incense. What was incense for? The same peace. Everyone say the same peace. The same peace offering. He's looking for peace in the house of God, not in the devil's shrine, not in any juju. No, in the sanctuary of who? The sanctuary of the Lord. And we're told, yeah, I was wroth. He was annoyed. Say, who are you to talk to me? Don't you know I am royal majesty? Don't you know I am president so-so-so? Don't you know I am governor so-so-so? Don't you know I am minister so-so-so? I'm senator so-so-so? Honorable member so-so-so? Don't you know I am his royal highness? Don't you know I am police commissioner? I'm police, you know, the DIG. I am AIG. I am inspector general. Don't you know who I am? I am his so-so-so-so. You are talking to me anyhow. You want to, he became annoyed. He couldn't take, listen to them. Bible says he was wroth with the priest. What happened? The leprosy, there was a leprosy, even rose up in his forehead before the priest in the house of the Lord from besides the incense altar. Where do leprosy came now? From the same God. And Azariah, the chief priest, and all the priests looked upon him, and behold, he was leprous in his forehead. And they thrust him out from thence. Yea, he himself has said also to go out, because the Lord have what? Smiting him. Mark this statement. They were telling him before, please go, please go. It's not appertaining to you. It appertains to the priest and the high priest, Azariah. It is according to command. I am the one that's supposed to perform. You are the one to rule all over us. He was wrought. Nobody could stop him. Nobody could challenge him. Nobody could correct him. Nobody could advise him. Every advice, he always say, I am right. I am right. You are wrong. I am right. What happened? Bible said, left with those 60 men and 61 men, they could not have pulled him away. He's ready to command his soldier to kill them. But there is only one person he could not pull, that could pull him. Who is that person? The only one person could. Bible says, before they know it, as he heard the incense on his hand and went to put fire, leprosy came upon him from the head to what? And all the priests saw him. They said, ah, you're a leper. You're a leper. Are they? Because no leper will be allowed here in the sanctuary. Bible says, and they were trying to push him away. He himself, pick grace. Everyone said, pick grace. God will visit the church. That people who are compromising will pick grace. I say, God will pick, visit these fishers of mankind from the headquarters to all the branches. God will visit his house in this time, that men will fear this God. I say, men will fear this God. That people will fear this God. Who refuse to pay their tithe, they will fear. Who refuse to go to evangelism, they refuse to amend their way. They refuse to obey the word of God. Who obey, disobey the pastor, disobey the leadership, I say, nothing can happen. Those who are stubborn, those who are rebellious. This man was so stubborn, so rebellious. Bible said, not only they were trying to force him away, Bible said, he himself hastened up to do what? To run away from where? From the sanctuary. Amen. Amen.
Beloved, if you have been blessed by this message, and you wish to give your life to Jesus Christ, say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I acknowledge that I'm a sinner. I come to you for mercy. Cleanse me with your blood and make me a new creature. As I accept you as my Lord and personal Savior, I will live for you all the days of my life. Amen. Congratulations, you are now a child of God. You can worship in any of our branch or any Bible-believing practicing church close to you.